Hello guys, it's Mickey. Welcome to my channel. If you're just into my channel, please subscribe, turn on the notification bell so as to be notified each time is an upload coming from me. So this is Mickey in a preggy state. I need to keep saying this, it's like my new motto. This is Mickey in a preggy state, so don't judge me yet, okay? And I'm beginning to have skin tag. I think I should probably get a new YouTube channel that talks about my pregnancy state. It's exciting, at the same time exhausting, but fun and scary at the same time. But it's, all in all, I feel really good. But I don't like how I look, but I feel really good that I'm gonna be a mother. You know that kind of expectant mother. Well, anyways, so I got some questions about the video I pulled out yesterday. Oh, Mickey, we missed you. It's been a while. Yeah, I know. I've been kind of skeptical about creating content because of how I look presently. But, you know, people say, oh, people have seen you before, Mickey. Come on, don't do that. This is the best time to even, you know, create content so that people would see, oh, you in your pregnancy state and after the pregnancy state and all that. So now I got some questions, as I said earlier, about yesterday's video. And one of the questions was, I wish I opened my laptop to check this. I'll try and remember. Was, Mickey, what do you mean by pure kojic acid? Is there anything known as pure kojic acid, or you are just saying it so that people say, oh, kojic acid is kojic acid? Kojic acid is not kojic acid, honey. It is not. All right. There's something you guys should know about chemical store, actually, when you're even buying products from chemical store. They have grades. Most of this powder, alpha-butene powder, glutathione, sepi white, giga white, they all have grades. They are gradable powders. All right. So when you want to buy them in a chemical store, you need to explain that you want first grade of those products. And that's why some people say, ah, we sell authentic powders, because they're giving you first grades. And first grade powders are way expensive. They are not cheap. Well, it says, some people say, oh, I bought my sepi white, but how much you buy your own? Ah, they cheated you. If you won't buy, I bought my own sepi white powder, 500 gram. I bought it for 7,000. My dear, you can't buy it for 7,000. It's not possible. All right. Most of these powders have grade. So if you're buying any of your powders, be it kojic acid, be it anything you want to use, any of your powders you want to use and you want to formulate, tell them you want first grade. All right, you need to go for first grade. The same thing with glutathione, same thing with alpha-butene powder, mostly alpha-butene powder, because that alpha-butene powder, there's so many fake in the market. You need to get first grade out of it. There's sometimes you buy alpha-butene powder, it looks like milk. You know, when you dissolve it, it's looking like milk. What is that? There was even one I got, because I actually knew it, I sent someone to go get it for me. They gave me giga white powder that looks like milk, and I said, oh yeah, take it back, where did you buy it? They said they bought it. I'm not going to mention the name so as not to spoil business for some people. And they said one certain name that was even odd. I said, I told you where to go and get these powders. Go get them there, don't go somewhere else, because you want to cut corners. And I have to call the person, please, this person is coming to buy, I just had to buy it online, so the person will just bring it for me. Right, so that's one of the question. The second one is, oh, why did you add citric acid? Why didn't you add ferulic acid to it? Citric acid is cheaper to get, and better to work with. Okay, and when you're using citric acid, it also needs measurement. You don't just rush and put any kind of citric acid inside your mix because you're trying to stabilize your kojic acid. It doesn't work that way. You need to get a measurement, right? Because someone is asking a question, oh, she wants to make this, what's the measurement she should put of citric acid? Your citric acid has to be measured, but it has to be in a small quantity, not too much, because citric acid, the major work of citric acid is just to help for stabilization. All right, and there's also this kit. I think I'll take my time to show you guys, probably when I get home, probably in another video, I don't know. I'll show you guys what I use to test the grade of your product. You need to test it test the grade of your product to see if it's it can be, if it's usable, if it's safe to use on the skin. But if it's not, then you'll be able to know the certain color it gives you. You know, then you just decide to use something to stabilize your product, right? Which I worked with, which was really, really good, because I didn't like the fact that my body wash was changing color. I hated it a lot. I hated it so much that when I make it, it was changing color. I'm like, shit, why? Why? And this time I didn't even change any product. I even added a higher grade of kojic acid. All right, see how crazy it is. And it's still the same color. It's still the same. I'll go get it. Okay, so this is the body wash. I had to tell my staff to go get it. You can see it hasn't changed. I haven't seen this body wash in this state before in my life. When I'm producing my body wash, even before it comes out and I tend to put it in the container, it has already changed color. All right, where I get I would say pissed off. You know, I'm like, oh, fucking hell, what is happening? People say, oh, you didn't add preservative. I added preservative. The thing still changed color. So this one, I guess maybe because of the citric acid alongside the preservative, just gave me a heads up. Really nice. I had to get the exact measurement of citric acid I wanted to add into it. But I'm still waiting to see if it's going to change color. That's what I'm still waiting for. But for now, see now. Aren't you liking this? It's the same price, because people keep asking, oh, how much is your blanch citrus? Now that it's looking bright, I'm very sure you changed bright. It's still 5,500. The price has not changed. It has not altered. It's the same blanch citrus. Nothing was removed. The only thing was removed fragrance. Right? Most of my customers don't want fragrances. Right? So we removed the fragrance. But this time, the powder we added was a higher grade of powder of kojic acid. And then we added citric acid. Citric acid is cheap, right? So I'm not going to say, oh, because I added citric acid, I should increase the money. Citric acid is actually way, way cheap. But I'm loving this, and I'm so impressed with myself. Like, seriously impressed. It hasn't changed. It hasn't altered. It hasn't moved. It's just that color. It's crazy. When I did my NAVDAC on my body wash, I noticed it also changed color, but I just had to... send it like that, all right? Because the color I gave in NAVDAC was not orange. Was it orange? It was, I think it was orange. I think that was the color it went for. I'll check my certificate. That was the color it went for. It's crazy, really, really crazy. So I got another question. The other question was still about yesterday's video. She said, since you knew about citric acid, why didn't you do it before now? Why are you just doing it now? Honey, there's something you should know about production. All right, this time around I did in a small batch. I'm going to take my time to show you guys. I did in a small batch, 16 pieces. I've never done my body wash in 16 pieces, either 50, 100 pieces. That's what I do, right? 50, 100 pieces, and it's not going to take long. It's out, so I make it fresh again, right? But this time I did just 16 pieces. I wanted to see how the citric acid was going to turn out, if it was going to turn out well or if it was going to be, you know, bad. But it came out really well, and I like what I'm seeing. I'm really impressed with myself. It's going to be a long video, but I'm really, really impressed with myself. All right. So that's one message. Another message. Some of you would get a message. You send me, instead of you replying to a message on YouTube, you go on Instagram. I don't understand. It doesn't work that way. All right. I can't be divided. Though I'm still the person on Instagram. Don't get me wrong. But I can't be everywhere. That's the thing. Okay. Most of my attention, because most of you ask questions for a long period of time. So I have to keep answering. Some of you would even ask the same question like over and over again, like want to bust my brains. But I need to keep replying. I need to keep my focus on you guys. Okay. So when you get a topic on YouTube, and I keep telling you, oh, please go back on YouTube, it's not to sound rude, because the thing even caused a squabble between myself and a customer. She said, oh, I saw a video of yours on YouTube. which one should I now go for? She's not even a new customer. That's the funniest thing. And I told her, please go back on YouTube. That is why we try as much as possible on YouTube to be explanatory enough. All right? So if you come on WhatsApp, when I'm on WhatsApp chatting, and you are not asking me a question on YouTube, my mind might not be there. My mind is in so many places. I do production. You know, then I used to teach. Now I don't teach. So nobody can tell me, oh, Mickey, I want to... People still ask, do you teach? I want to learn. You cannot learn from me. Because my head is everywhere. And I do production in large bunch for people who buy in wholesale. It's a lot of work. Eh? And to edit videos, that's why you can, if you notice, I've been so absent on YouTube. But right now, my dear, I'm back. Yeah, I'm back like I never left. You know, I've been so absent on YouTube because the workload is a lot. And the work, the stuff I went through in Okwebi, it really got me in a bad state. Financially, you know, it really, really, it tumbled. It just made me so bad. You know, and I don't want to feel that way because the only thing that is giving me joy right now, that's why I'm having this new look and this new, you know, new phase of life is my baby. That's the only thing. Because I've been looking for a child for a long time, a really long time. I'm going to be honest with you. You know, it's just that I'm just a private person. I don't come out and I'm looking for a baby. That's why someone was asking me, when did you get a husband? When did you? It's not every cooking shake go anyway. I'm feeling sorrow. If you know what I mean. My life is private and my business is public. So please patronize my public business and leave my private business alone. I'm just naughty. So that's why it's just the Okwebi store really got me down after, you know, wasting that kind of money and one crazy landlord. Just, I don't know, should I say envy or I don't know, just say Lagos landlords are just like that. But that thing really affected me financially. Put me, it's almost got to a stage where I almost got depressed, right? But no, God knows how it works, his wonders. And boop, this one popped in. Like poop, poop. You know, God just wanted to use it to bless me. I guess so. I am really excited. I've never been so happy in all my life. Like never, ever, ever. Ever, 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 ever. So, if you guys still have more questions, I still have questions to answer. But right now, this video is long. So, I'm sure I'm going to cut some. All right, I'm gonna see you guys in my next YouTube video, and I love you guys to bits like kilo day. Bye, guys.